Assalamualaikum, hallo en hartelijke welkom bij Proe. Ek is Abida Dixon Mohammed. Vandaag keer ek bij Abdul Basit Kolbe. En ek wil ook net vir jy sê baie baie dankie, want vandag is die laaste episode van seisoen 15. Nou jylle onthou ons nou verlede week en ek moes nou gaan keier vir Fatima Kolbe. En ons het ons so lekker gepraat oor haar man, te dink ek nie, wacht, hier moet ek vir Abdul Basit, moet ek in die hande kry, want ek hoor ons hy kan koop, hy is so 'n goeie man, en hy doen al die dinge, so laat ek gou sien of hy kan al die goeders doen. Salam alaikum, Abdul Basit. ek gaan nie, my kids gaan ek by al die vraag uitkom wat jou vrou vir my gegee het. Ons los gou eerste daai, ons is in die kombuis. Abdul Basit, wat gaan jy vandag vir my doen?
So today we planning on making pink almond biscuits.
Oh, want ek het nou net gedog, ons gaan net bly by pink. Ek wil nou net gesê, pink. Okay, almond biscuits, yeah. Daar is die mooi woord. Gee gou vir ons mense, wat se bestanddele gebruik
jy? Okay, so we'll be starting with 250 grams of pure butter.
Ja.
Not mavello, pure butter.
Jo, maar dat is mos duur.
We obviously we want to taste the biscuit in the best form, you know.
Alright.
And then we have 1.5 cups of caster sugar.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we have cake flour, 3.5 cups of cake flour.
Mm-hmm.
We have some extra flour there, you know, just for later on.
Yeah.
And then 1/2 cup of fish oil. We have a teaspoon of baking flour.
Baking powder,
apologies, right. And then we have 1 egg,
yes.
And the almonds as well, 250 grams almonds.
And then we have 2 bottles?
Yeah, so we have strawberry essence and pink crimson.
Okay.
Crimson pink.
Maar waarmee begin jy? Maar voor jy gou begin, jy het al gepraat van koekmeel. Kan een mens ook self rising flour gebruik?
Unfortunately not, dis cake flour.
A cake flour, alright. That's it, ons los hem so. Abdul Basit, wat gaan jy sê in
jou botte? So we start with the butter.
Okay, so ek gaan hoeveel in?
Put the butter in for me.
Ja.
And then the sugar over here.
Yes.
So what we're going to do is just we're going to break this apart. The butter needs to obviously stand out of the fridge. So, you know, it's
soft. Ja, laat hy 'n bietjie sagter is.
Because this is what's going to get a bit messy to get the butter. Mm. We need to make this creamy. So this is the mission, you know.
Okay.
Maar
laat ek gou by jou hoor, as ek nou nie kaste sugar het,
yeah.
Maar ek het nou gewone suiker, kan ek daai sommer gebruik?
Ja, you see, this is fine, right, the caster sugar. So what you can do is, you can take normal sugar,
yeah.
And you can just grind it up, and make it fine, and it will work as well.
Wel, dan moet ek gaan eerlijk genoeg wees om te sê, ek het eens geweet, een mens kan gewone suiker gebruik, en het net fijn maak, daar leer hy alweer van my iets. Ek sê dit elke dag, ons wat dink, ons ken nie alles, die jongspan, hulle kan vir ons een ding of twee leer. Nou, daai moet nou lekker fijn is, so, as ek nou mag vraag, jy sikkel nou gauw om hom fijn te maak, maar sal gesmelte boter beter wees, hè?
No, it's not going to work because what you need is you need the butter texture to go through the sugar. So if it's melt, you're not gonna get if it's melted, you're not gonna get the full texture you need.
Jo, is daar maar streng teetje, jong. Jo, ik denk nog, ik kan kort pad vatten, maar het weet glad is zo niet.
So you see the butter has been standing out of the fridge for about 2 days.
Yes.
But it's still a bit odd because of the weather. So you want it to, you know, to be as soft as possible.
Kijk hier, ek dacht, we sit maar op die microwave, die hele tijd gelos, so elke keer as die microwave aan gaan, dan gaan die heat op.
Yeah, what we used to do is, if you make biscuits in a rush, you know, we leave the butter close to the pot where we make, you know, so it can
maar
get a bit soft.
Maar hy moet nou sachter word. Maar okay, kom ek sê nou, hy is nou amper daar waar hy hem nou het,
ja?
Dan gebruik jy nou daai dingetje om hem nou verder mee creamy te maak.
You can add the egg in here as well.
So maar nou?
Ja.
Well, alright. Niks stoppen nie, laat ons kyk. Daar sê.
There we go.
Niks stoppen daar nie. Okay.
And then, as soon as we get this a bit more creamy, we'll add the fish oil.
Ja. Nou, as ek mag vraag, sal een virkie nou nie beter gewees het as die lepel nie?
Unfortunately, I love a wood spoon because you need to put pressure. And if you use any other spoon, it's in a bend, you know.
Ja, die man, ek moet sê, die ouwe het elke keer een different antwoord van my Isa, maar nee, man. Yo, hoe
so you can see over here, this is what the butter, pure butter does. If you had to use melted butter, you wouldn't have get this.
Okay. Maar nou, laat ek nou gauw nou Man, jy gooi my nou heeltemal uit. Jy sê ek moet nou echte botter gebruik. Maar nou, mense het moet sê altyd die nie, man. Man
that's,
nou,
well, that's why I buy the butter when it's on special only. And I stock it up. So, but it tastes different, totally okay. Different if you use like Mavello or any other
yes.
Butter. Because the, you know, the richness of the pure butter is what you want to taste in the biscuits.
Okay. Maar dan, ek moet vir jou eerlijk waar sê, ek hou van my Mavello, ne? En ek doen omtrent alles met my Mavello. So, ek gaan vir hom sy duw gee vir echte botter, maar ek gaan maar bly by my Mavello. Alright, so nou gaan
so
hy
weg. So, let me do this a bit.
Mm-hmm.
So, you want to put it on slow?
Yes.
First, so it don't, you know, spatter all over. What I've did, I've learned the first time I started this, I put it on high and all over the floor.
I can imagine.
So you want to get the sugar nicely through, you know? You can add the fish oil now as well.
Biki for biki of alles.
Yeah, you can put all in.
Alles.
Over there. There we go. So that's what you want to do. So this is what the results is, you know,
yes.
Of pure butter.
Ah, maar daar kan maar van my man is nog wel convinced met pure butter. Ja, maar zo
so now, as you see, it's a bit runny, so now you can put it higher.
Okay.
En ik leg zo maar die turbo te gebruiken. So it goes a bit quicker, you know.
That's technology. Heb jullie nog een woord voor mijn Afrikaans uit, ne? Ik denk van niet, hij is kwijt los. Het lijkt nou op zo'n mespotatoes, ne? Oké. En als hij, dan wat gaan we nou om?
So now you can put a teaspoon of strawberry essence. Okay. Strawberry essence, it's for flavor.
Yeah.
There we go. And you can throw half a teaspoon of crimson pink. It all depends on the color as well. You don't want to have it, you know.
Okay, half a teaspoon.
Eh? Yeah. Okay. Here we go.
Okay.
So we'll add more maybe later.
Yeah. Maar hij lijkt nogal prachtig.
You see the color changes now. To pink. Over there.
Ja, wat mooi. Nogal een mooi baby pink, ne?
Ja.
Yeah.
So you can throw more in, it will just turn more pink or it comes purple, you know. You don't want to have too much.
Hmm.
So I think this is... We'll have to see later on, you know, when we throw a flower in, the color goes a bit away.
Okay. So now, daar gaan jou meel in.
So you can add the flower in now,
kan
yeah?
Kan maar nou.
Ja.
Sprinkle of gooi net so daar?
There we go.
Sprinkle.
So the flower sifted already.
Yes.
So
okay,
we do
so
that. Throw the baking powder in as well.
In?
No. Okay. No problem. What we can do is we can...
Oh my word.
Not a problem. So that.
Ik heb nog een extra meel ingegooid.
Yeah, that's fine.
Ach, dat is daarom dom. Dat is zo prachtig.
So, let's just to get it, you know, with me. We don't want to have the mixture too dry. Because it will end up breaking when we actually press it, you know.
Okay, so basis, alles is nog klaar in. Wanneer gaan jou walnuts in?
Het is shortly after.
Ja, je gaat ook zomaar daar. Wel, oké, zoals je kan nu zien, hij zit alles bij elkaar. Walnuts gaan in en dan is hij klaar. Dan wordt hij net uitgerold en dan zal hij natuurlijk zijn biscuits maken. Ons is nog weer terug. Ik zie nou daar jou dingetje lijkt aan baie mooi. Wat kleur het, die deeg of wat ook al. En het is mooi gevormd. So wat doen jy nou?
So now we're going to just roll it out. You can throw it with flour.
Okay.
So don't...
Net to sprinkle.
There we go.
Okay.
Now we stick it lekker. So this is what we've made. Just put it out like that.
Yes.
And we can do this, make.
Okay.
You use this.
En kijk hoe pink is my vingers hier. Net van het doppie wat ik opgemaakt heb.
So we're going to roll it out like this.
Okay. Kijk hier, ik heb een paar van jou almost gestolen.
So we use this so it don't stick on the, you know, on the Pas de.
Oké, aan die rolstok vast. Ja. Oké.
Okay. En dat way. Dat is hier weer.
Goeie idee. Daar zijn. Jouw nuts is nog opgeëerd.
So you don't want to make it too thick or too thin?
Mm-hmm. As ik het dun maak, gaan het breek.
Not really. Ze gaan het minder eet.
Hoe baie maak je dit?
Niet la barang tijd.
La barang tijd. Oké. Behalve die wat bak je nog?
Love baking my special chocolate cake.
So, as ek nou mag vra, as jy 'n bakker?
When I have time, I will do it. If I have cravings for something sweet or something nice, then I will bake chocolate cake or pudding. Sometimes I'll make, you know, old tart.
Ek gaan maar niks sê nie. Want as ek nou moet hoor wat mense kan bak, gaan ek maar my mond toe. Want hulle weet mos nou al by die tyd, as ek mos nou nie 'n bakker nie.
Okay, so we'll just start cutting it out maybe from this side.
Yeah.
But before we do that, this is what the fork is for. Just to give it a nice texture on the biscuit, you know.
Yeah.
So the biscuit doesn't come out too flat.
Oh. And we say, what's it nog weer van die?
My mother.
Ooh, mom. Clever mom, no?
So opposite side. There we go.
Oké. Okay. Kijk, jij zei, ik heb maar dit stukje pro.
There we go. So we can cut them out like that.
Pro, klaar zo lekker, mini nuts. En kan ik niet imagine hoe gaan ik pro als ik klaar is. Abdu Basit nou so 'n bietjie jonger was, het hy nou ooit gedink dat hy miskien in die kombuis nou koekies kan gaan bak?
I used to eat this while it's raw, while my mother used to make it.
Soos ek het nou gedoen.
Ja, so as het altyd my handen geslaat, wait till it's finished. So what you do is you take that out like that, lift up the biscuit over there, put him in this over there.
Okay. Kom maar, jy moet ook maar mooi kyk om te sien waar sit, ne?
Ja, so license.
Okay, so that I know.
Take that out.
Oh, en dan basis nou die rest wat maar oorbly, vou jy maar weer by mekaar en so gaan jy maar aan en aan en aan. Nou, as jy nou hierdie goede maak, maak jy het net vir die huis of maak jy ook vir mense om te koop en te verkoop?
As I make, I always give tools to my family, my friends, and they always ask and put their orders in for special days. So, I'm a very generous person. I won't say no, I'll do it because I love doing it.
Okay.
And I love eating, so I know when I make someone an order, I'll also have for myself to eat. So, that's why I'll make it, you know.
Okay. So, het julle nou gehoor? Hy is a baie generous person, so jylle kan maar order. Jylle kan maar order, ne?
There we go. So you have to be very careful when you pick it up.
So dat jy nou precies kan sien dat jy hom nou nie raak snij of afbreek of 'n dingie.
Ja.
So dat jy nou mooi die dingiekie kry.
There we go.
Alright. En as jy nou, sit jy nog iets hierbo op, of is het net so plein, want die nuts is klaar in, ne? Nou, jy gebruik nou die almonds. Kan jy ook whole nuts gebruik?
Unfortunately, I've tried it, but it burns all the whole nuts.
Okay.
So.
Maar dis almonds, aan beide nuts.
Yeah, you see, the almonds, they have a different layer. So I think is that layer itself that burns in the oven. So you want to actually taste the nuts.
En ik denk misschien om a walnut is misschien omdat hij is misschien een beetje meer harder.
Ja. No? Sometimes I would love to try cashew nuts, you know. Okay. The next time I make it. It's a bit expensive. and I think before the cashew nuts will reach,
yes,
the biscuits will be done. Because I'm a lover of cashew nuts.
Dan zeg
so, ja.
Oké. So, yeah. Okay. So by the time as it klaar is, is er niks meer cashew nuts.
So what we can do is just put this together again. Okay, so you just do the same
again.
Process,
yeah.
But we can do is work on this side, yeah, as well.
I see now what you mean.
Can do with the other side, leave it all here.
So jy doen basis maar die, as jy nou, kom ek sê, tyd vir jouself en dan sal jy maar vir jou besig hou.
Yes, it does take time, because you have to wash the biscuits in the oven within 5 to 10 minutes. So,
okay,
you have to continuously keep an eye on it. We don't want it to burn at the end of the day.
Nou, maar over die bak kan jy ook kook.
I do cook, yes. My favorite dish, crayfish curry.
Weet jy.
So you're going to do the same process again over there?
Ja, yeah, en dan gaan jy maar te keer en so aan.
Just really gentle.
Alright, maar wel soos jy nou kan sien, die ou, hy kan, soos hy sê, hy kan kook en hy kan bak. Daar het hy nou gewys. En ek moet sê, hierdie deegie, soos het nou hele proef fantastisch, vir al myn die nuts binnen. Dit gee sommer hy lekker, lekker smaak. En as hy klaar lekker is, terwijl hy rou is, kan ek my net indink, hoe gaan hy proe as hy gaar is. Bly ingeskakel, ons gaan vir jy wys, wanneer het gaar is. Biscuits is nou in die oond. Maar toe hoor ek, die ou kan nie net bakkie, hy kan ook kook, en nou verstaan ek, hy ran ook sy eie besigheid. Slim. Maar nou wil ek gewoon bykie by hom nou hoor, hoe werk die story nou met die besigheid? Abdul Basit, jou eie events company, vertel gauw vir ons een bykie.
So, the events company is called Aspire Promotions.
Okay.
We've been registered now for 3 years. And the company specializes in events management, hosting, and fundraising as well.
Okay.
We look at, obviously, doing your event for you from A to Z. With our specialities and our marketing team that makes sure that your event goes known out there. People see your event, people speak about your event, and so far the events industry, it's been a very good industry to be in, in terms of networking with various people. And I think that's important, you know, meeting lots of people throughout your events career, basically.
Okay, nou jy het nou genoem van event van A tot Z.
Ja.
Wat beteken alles van A tot Z?
So, not any event, it needs decorating, it needs planning, it needs marketing, it needs catering, it needs publicity.
Yes.
So all of these things, we can put it together for you, and makes it easier for the client at the end of the day, you know, not to have all of the stress.
Okay.
So I handle the stress, and I'm not great yet, so I think I can still handle it more. So that's basically just to make the client happy, you know. Feeling comfortable with the event, understanding that we'll take care of the event for you.
Yes.
Basically, everything from sound, from marketing, planning, everything we do is.
Yeah. But now, praat ons misschien nog van een clear schema. Mensen het ons nou hulle eie kleren in mind en by. Nou kom ek sê nou, hier kom ek en ek soek nou oranje.
Yeah.
Maar nou word jou oranje nie weer gebruik oor 1 jaar of 2 nie. Hmm. Wat maak jy nou met dan?
So we try to understand the idea that the client would like to do, you know, in terms of the theme. And then we work around that. And we try to keep it unique for each client. So no theme would be necessarily the same for each client, unless they want it. But we always advise them to break it, you know, to do something unique, something different. And that is the mission of Aspire Promotions, is to provide unique events, something different, whether it's a different lineup or a different theme. And we'll try to use that particular theme or color in another event, you know, just to break it. Or always use it at a later stage as well.
Okay. Nou, jy het genoem nou van catering en daai. So dit wil dan sê, jylle het dan ook jylle eie waiters en alles ook?
So what we do is, basically we outsource some of the work for individuals, for businesses, and to promote them as well, growing their brand. So as part of the events, advertising, we'll market them if it is that we outsource a particular catering company or a particular deco company. We'll do marketing for them as well at the same time.
Maar nou, as ek vir jou nou die vraag mag vra as a Muslim, en jylle is mos nou an events company, kyk jylle net vir Muslims of ook vir nie Muslims?
No, we open to everyone. All backgrounds. We've had clients from various nationalities, and that shouldn't be a problem, you know. At the end of the day, business is business. As long as my client is happy, and we look at building long-term relationships with them, and that's important, the networking with them, to obviously make them happy at the end of the day.
Nou, het jy dalk miskien al 'n client gekry wat nie so happy was, he?
At the moment, from up to date, not as yet.
Oh, well, so,
yeah, we try to keep our clients happy as much as possible, and also to follow up with them in terms of how did they find the event, would they like to do more events with us, you know, these questions we like to throw up on them, and also take them out for a treat, you know, just to find out everything is well, especially if it's, for example, a wedding. We like to check up on the couple, you know, how they're doing and so forth.
Okay. Nou, jy praat so gedurig nou van we and we and we. Wie is we and we?
So the team at large, Aspire Promotions, consists of a few individuals that specialize in marketing strategies, that specialize in planning as well. Myself, I would give the credit to my wife as well. She helps me with my planning.
Okay.
We'll sit late nights up and discuss and work around a few things. We have quite a few people that is involved in the company, and that's the success of it, you know. I myself can't do it on my own, so I have to give the credit to the whole team.
Okay. Maar nou, daar word ons altyd gesê dat 'n man en 'n vrou nie moet saamwerk in besigheid nie. Wat is jou opinie?
Well, it becomes a time where you feel like doing decisions on your own.
Yes.
And that's when I get it, when she tells you, just do what you want to. So then I do what I want to, and keeping consideration of the client's interest, you know.
Yes.
So it becomes a time we'll clash, but there's understanding on that, and we make up for it, you know. As long as we know this is for the interest of the client, the best interest, and as long as we know that what we're doing, it's business, and when we go back home, it's basically husband and wife.
Yes. Want ek wil nou net sê, dink jy dit sal dan ook beter wees wanneer man en vrou saamwerk in 'n besigheid, dat wanneer hulle besig is met die besigheid, dan moet hulle gedagtes wees, hulle moet nie dan dink aan man en vrou nie, hulle moet dan dink as my partner of wat ook al, op daai oomblik. En ek dink as hulle werk op daai gedagte, dan sal die clash ook nie altyd so kom nie. Maar ek dink is omdat hulle al gewoond is, dis my man, dis my vrou, en dit is waar die verkeerde ding eindelijk inkom.
Definitely. I couldn't agree much more. I would like to thank her, you know, for always being there for me in terms of support, and whether I'm deciding on something, she would always, you know, jump in and reprimand me, you know, in other words. So big thanks to her as well.
Maar ek moet daarom sê, dat kos 'n man om op televisie te sê hy appreciate sy vrou vir wat hy sy vaar doen. So Fatima Colby, jy is 'n gelukkige vrou. Well, Abdul Basit, ek sê vir jou baie, baie shukr en mag Allah baie barakat aan jylle events het, inshallah.
Thank you for opportunity.
Wel, Nadi, ek die biscuits proe. En kyk jylle die ouse biscuits, jylle speel met die ou. Ha, het lyk te kwaai. Abdul Basit, het op gauw voor ons weer dier die bestand jylle?
So 3.5 cups of cake flour. I'll put in 1.5 cups of caster sugar, a teaspoon of baking powder, half a cup of fish oil, and 250 grams of the whole nuts itself. And then the half, 250 grams of butter as well. We'll add in there. And that's your biscuit that you'll find.
Nou, Abdelbasi, die was nou jou bestanddele. Maar ek moet vir jy sê, ek weet nie of jy opgelet het nie, maar met drie hapies het ek gevat. En ek gaan vir jy sê, hierdie biscuits, soos ons al sê, beskuitjes, was vir jou nou fabulous. Want hierboor, ek het alle nou gelag, toe ek nou sê, ek noem so maar hierdie wat hy gemaakt het met die virkie, nee, is amper soos krimmels wat boop is. Maar hy proe lekker en die nuts. Mensen, maar ek moet sê, hierdie ou kent sy story. Abdelbasi, gou weer, jy het nou genoem jou bestanddele wat jy nou hier ingesit het en alle type van goeders. Jy het ook vroeger genoem, in 'n paar sekondes, genoem van jou hou van 'n chocolate cookie en alle type van goeders. Jou chocolate cookse bestanddele, is het min of meer amper soos hierdie?
So, instead of using cake flour, I'll use half raisin flour for the cake. That's the only difference. You will add like your oil, we'll go in there, fish oil, your eggs, your butter, your sugar as well, something similar, and obviously the cocoa and the water goes together for the texture.
And that's a chocolate cook love.
Yeah.
Well, I can for you say, hierdie ou, nee wat, ek dink ek gaan hom weer kom keer wanneer hy chocolate cook maak, maar bly ingeskakel, ek proe sommer lekker.
En ek hoop jy die dag saam met my en Abdelbasi lekker geniet. Weer eens sê ek jy baie baie dankie om deel te kon wees van seisoen 15. Wel, wanneer ek weer met jy gesels dan is dit lente. En ja, dan is dit die eerste episode van seisoen 16 en ek gesels met Nadia Slamang in haar kombuis.